So good morning, my dear students. In this video we will discuss artificial pollination. In artificial pollination, two different varieties of crop plant with the desired characters are selected. First we will select the two different varieties of crop with desired characters. After selection, these varieties are crossbreed to produce new variety of plant with required characteristics. Clear all of you? So in artificial pollination, we will select two different varieties of crop plant with the good characters, and after selection, these varieties are crossbreed to produce new variety of plant, and that new plant will possess good characters. For example, one variety of wheat is high yielding and the other variety of wheat is disease resistant. If both the varieties are crossbred by artificial pollination, we get a variety of wheat plant which has both the desired characteristics from the parent plant. Clear? See to this once more. Example, one variety we have high yielding, other variety is disease resistant. If both varieties are crossbred by artificial pollination, we get a variety of wheat plant which has both desired characters. It means new plant that will be formed will be disease resistant also, as well as high yielding and disease resistant. Clear? Next, my dear students, the hybrid variety is very important to agriculture. It improves the quality. Now this whole process is called hybridization. This whole process is known as hybridization, and the new formed variety is called hybrid. The whole process is called hybridization, and new formed variety is called hybrid. The hybrid variety is very important to agriculture. For agriculture, it is very important. It improves quality and productivity of cultivated crop plants. Many high yielding varieties of wheat, maize, rice are developed by the process of hybridization. Clear? You'll find many high yielding varieties of wheat, maize, rice. Clear? Which are being developed by the process of hybridization. Next, we shall discuss fertilization. My dear students, fertilization means fusion of male gamete and female gamete to form zygote is called fertilization. So definition of fertilization, all of you have to learn. Fusion of male and female gamete. Clear? Fusion of male and female gamete is known as fertilization. Plant reproduce sexually by the process of fertilization. In this process, the male cell or pollen fuse together with the female cell to form single cell called zygote. So fertilization is the fusion of male gamete and female gamete to produce zygote. Male cells or pollen it act as male gamete, and the female cell or egg cell act as female gamete. So this fusion of male gamete and female gamete, the process of fusion of male gamete and female gamete to form zygote is called fertilization. Clear? Fertilization. Now let us discuss next. So in the fertilization, zygote is formed. Clear? Male gamete and female gamete fused together, zygote is formed. From the zygote, embryo is formed, and embryo that it turns into seed, and seed grows into a new plant. The process of fertilization takes place in the following steps. Now we shall discuss the steps of fertilization. First step, let us see. Step 1. Step 1. The pollen grains fall on the stigma. Pollen grain will fall on a stigma by absorbing water and nutrients from the stigma. It germinates. So pollen grains, after falling on the stigma, it germinates and produce two nuclei, tube nucleus and germinative nucleus. So pollen grain, after it falls on the stigma, then it produces two nuclei, tube nucleus and germinative nucleus. Then next step 2, the tube nucleus forms pollen tube. Tube nucleus, it will form pollen tube. Tube nucleus will form pollen tube and germinative nucleus, it divides to form two male nuclei. Clear? So first, this tube nucleus, it will form pollen tube and germinative nucleus, it forms two male nuclei. Now this pollen tube grows through the style. The pollen tube grows through the style and finally reaches ovule of the ovary through micropyle. Micropyle is the hole. It is a hole in the egg, in the female egg, through which this pollen tube enters the egg. Clear? Next, my dear student, fourth point you see. One of the two male nuclei present in the pollen tube fuses with the egg cell. Now, I have told you earlier, there are two male nuclei. One of the two male nuclei, it will fuse with egg cell to form zygote, which develop into embryo. So there are two male nuclei. Out of the two male nuclei, one male nuclei fuses with the egg cell and forms a zygote, which develops into embryo. The zygote further develops into an embryo. Next, we have fifth point, the other male nucleus. The other male nucleus fuses with polar nuclei to form endosperm. So one male nuclei fuses with the egg cell to form zygote and zygote forms embryo, and the other male nuclei fuses with polar nuclei of ovule to form endosperm, which nourishes the developing embryo. Clear? So in this way the fertilization takes place. I have explained it further. In this process of fertilization, fusion of male gamete and female gamete takes place. First of all, the pollen grains, they come to stigma. Listen carefully. First of all, the pollen grains will come, the pollen grains, it will come to the stigma. And the pollen tube germinates. You will find there are two types of nucleus, tube nucleus and generative nucleus. This generative nucleus further, it divides into two, germinative nucleus, it divides into two sperm nuclei or two male nuclei. Clear? One male nuclei One male nuclei that fuses with egg cell to form zygote, and the other, it will form the endosperm. So my dear student, just see to this diagram. In this diagram also we can see this one. On this stigma, pollen grains used to come. देन पोलन ट्यूब अराइजेस, दिस पोलन ट्यूब एंटर्स द एग क्लियर थ्रू द माइक्रोपाइल, हियर इट इज माइक्रोपाइल, थ्रू दिस माइक्रोपाइल इट एंटर्स द एग, देन डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस हियर, डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस हियर, वन मेल न्यूक्लियस फ्यूजेस विद द एग सेल टू फॉर्म जायगोट एंड जायगोट्स कन्वर्ट इन टू एम्ब्रियो एंड द अदर वन इट फ्यूजेस विद द पोलार न्यूक्लियाई क्लियर, वन अदर फ्यूजेस विद द पोलार न्यूक्लियाई टू फॉर्म एंडोस्पर्म, टू फॉर्म द एंडोस्पर्म, इफ यू गॉट अंडरस्टूड. So you can see here polar nuclei unite with one sperm nucleus to form endosperm nucleus, egg unite with one sperm nucleus to form the zygote. Clear, these are the two conditions, these were the two conditions my dear students. Now let us move further. This is the last topic of this chapter, difference between pollination and fertilization. Let us discuss one by one. First, pollination. Pollination, it is a physical process. Pollination is a physical process. Fertilization is physico-chemical process. Pollination is physical process and fertilization physico-chemical process. In the pollination, transfer of pollen grains takes place from anther to the stigma of flower. In the pollination, the transfer of pollen grains takes place from the anther to the stigma of flower. And in fertilization, fusion of male and female gamete takes place. These are the definition of pollination and fertilization, which we have discussed earlier. Clear? Next, third point, last. External agents may be required to complete the process, and fertilization is internal process which take place within the ovule of the ovary. Clear? So these are the differences between pollination and fertilization, my dear students. Difference between pollination and fertilization. And this is the end of this chapter also, chapter 2. In the next video, we shall discuss the book exercise. Clear? So in the next video, we will discuss the book exercise. Now this chapter gets here end. This is the end of this chapter, my dear students. Thank you very much.